All that you get to create an amazing frame in wildlife photography is 3 seconds. Wildlife photography is a 3-second magic game. If you have a friend who is passionate about wildlife photography, this video is right for him. Make sure you share this video with them. Do like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Wildlife photography is one of the fascinated genres of photography and is also considered to be the toughest genre of photography as well. I would not accept this is the toughest genre of photography. All the genres have their own tough part and all the genres have their own advantages and disadvantages. So there is equal amount of advantage and disadvantage in each and every genre of photography. But this particular genre of photography involves direct interaction with wild animals. So there is a high risk involved in this particular genre of photography. I said so because this genre of photography involves wild animals, whereas the other genre of photography mainly involves humans and the products that is created by humans, except the nature photography. You have a subject such as a wild animal and shoot that particular subject in its own environment. For you to do that, you should have a good knowledge on the subject as well as the environment that you are shooting in. This particular genre of photography has a lot of unexpected happenings that happen right in front of you in the particular environment. The subject, you do not know how it would react. You can guess it up to a certain extent, like up to 90%, but you can't predict it 100 out of 100. So the maximum time that you have is just 3 seconds. I hope you got it right. It is 3 seconds, which is 3000 milliseconds, which is an ample amount of time. Before you click on the shutter button, you have certain things that you will have to check. Let me give you the checklist. Spot your subject. This seems to be very easy in words, but when you get directly into the field, it is very tough. It is not so easy to spot the wild animals. They camouflage so well with the environment they are in. So spotting a subject is very tough and you would have to do that. Fix the frame. Create a frame in such a way that you understand the framing concept and you create maximum attraction towards your subject in that particular frame. And creating that is very much necessary. Composition. Creating a composition is a talent, and through a greater composition you can convey a story within the particular frame. Learn how to compose your image. ET parameters, exposure triangle parameters, all the three parameters such as shutter speed, aperture and ISO, all three are set perfect for the image and there is no histogram shift towards highlights or shadows, and there is a perfect histogram bend and you get the perfect exposure for your frame. Autofocus. Make sure your lens is set to autofocus. This works in most of the cases, but in some hard situations where the subject is far behind the bushes and branches in foreground, it is tough for the camera to focus such a subject. But the modern day lenses are very sharp. They focus even in such situations. But if your camera fails, make sure you shift it to manual and do a fast focusing. Autofocusing points. Make sure you set the perfect autofocusing points for your camera in that particular situation. In case your camera fails to autofocus, you just shift the autofocusing point that you have previously set, which may be a zonal or 61 autofocusing points. So you can change it to a single point and focus right on the eye of the subject and get the autofocus working for your subject in that particular situation. Metering. Choosing the perfect metering and setting the perfect exposure for your frame is very much necessary. Image quality. Make sure you shoot in RAW, which is very much necessary so that you do not lose on any details while you shift your image from shooting to post-processing. Gear stabilization. Make sure there is gear stabilization that is done automatically and manually as well. Switch on the IS mode on your lens for image stabilization, as well as make sure there is a flat base wherein you have placed your camera without any shake and you're shooting, which is very much necessary when you go for high weighted telephoto lenses, which are not recommended for handheld photography anytime. Direction of light. Placing the subject in the direction of light and making sure the light falls directly on the subject is very much necessary. If you fall in a case wherein you find or spot a species for the first time in your life and it is in backlight, and that is the situation, you will have to expose or set the exposure accordingly and click the particular image. I wouldn't recommend you to go ahead and click any subject on a backlight because it wouldn't be an interesting frame. Pre-visualize your frame. For you to achieve successfully the previous 10 checklist, you will have to pre-visualize. Pre-visualize only can happen if you have a good knowledge on the subject as well as the environment, so that you can pre-visualize your particular frame in that particular environment. And you can set your exposure and get all the checklists done within a matter of 3 seconds or 3000 milliseconds. I have made a separate video on how to pre-visualize and how to achieve pre-visualization, so do check out that video. These are the 11 things that you have to do and the checklist that you have to complete before you go ahead and click on the shutter button within 3 seconds. If you're watching this video until now, do go ahead and hit the like button and comment down below. It seems to be very tough for you to achieve such a huge checklist in 3 seconds. It is very easy. I will tell you how to make it happen in the upcoming video. Stay tuned.